Chapter 4, Intention to Create a Legal Relation. If two or more parties have an intention to enter into a legal relationship, the contract is binding and enforceable. The many family arrangements we enter in our daily lives are not expected to be enforceable. Hospitality being offered and accepted definitely cannot be enforceable. Courts have already decided that family matters do not have an intention to create a legal relation, where commercial matters do have an intention to create legal relations. To test if there is really any legal relation, we must find the objective of the relationship. The doctrine of intention to create a legal relationship is closely related to the doctrine of offer and acceptance and the doctrine of consideration. The doctrine of consideration states that a promise is enforceable when there is something exchanged for that promise to be kept. There must be an exchange of value between both parties. The doctrine of offer and acceptance focuses on the meeting of the mind, consensus ad idem. There has to be a mutual agreement on the terms of the contract before the contract can be binding. There is a fine distinction between these three doctrines. These three doctrines overlap in their view of the intention of creating a contract. Commercial settings. Okay, in the commercial setting, McCamus describes that there are two kinds of situations where the requisite of intention is not present. Where party express themselves and are bound in honor. In this case, there could be the absence of intention. Parties negotiating an agreement may achieve and record in writing a preliminary version of their agreement. All right, explicit agreement not to be bound. Party could have an agreement not to enter into a legal agreement. However, in the case Ron and Frank Company versus J.R. Crompton and Brothers Limited, the court declared that this agreement was enforceable. There are two reasons for this decision. First one is the provision of memorandum of the other agreement seems to be a binding agreement. Number two, the court viewed that the clause was unenforceable on the basis that it was contrary to public policy as an improper attempt to oust the jurisdiction of the court. The Court of Appeal repealed the decision. They said that it was impossible for parties to come to an agreement by accepting a proposal with the result that the agreement concluded does not give rise to a legal relation. Okay, number two, tendering process. The Supreme Court of Canada ruled that decision in the case Ron Engineering and Construction Eastern Limited versus Ontario that the tender is an offer that is accepted by the submission of a bid. This will create a contract. The traditional doctrine states that the tender call is not an offer, that all changed under the new rule created in Ron Engineering. Okay. The contract A and B analysis seems a bit complex. But let me see if I can try to explain this properly. Contract A is the tender contract that is made between a bidder. When a bidder submits a bid in response to an invitation to tender. If the issuing party of the tender selects contract A, the bidder would enter into contract B. Contract B is the contract that is formed between the owner and the winning bidder. There are obligations on both parties and the bidder. Okay, number three, letter of comfort. This is a letter issued by the lending company to the parent company. It lets the company know that the subsidiary company has been approved for financing. In order to provide the loan, the bank or the lender would require the parent company to provide a guarantee. The parent company might not want to give a guarantee. Instead, they can agree to the terms of a letter of comfort. In the case Kleinworth Benson Limited Malaysia Mining Corp, the Court of Appeal ruled that the comfort letter is not enforceable. There were three clauses in the contract. The doctrine of intention creates a legal relation. There was no intention because the defendant refused to give a guarantee and gave a letter of comfort as an alternative. The third paragraph imposed a moral obligation or responsibility to obey the defendant. To obey the defendant in respect of the debts of the subsidiary. Okay, number four. Preliminary agreement, letter of intent, and agreement subject to contract. This is a record of agreement that has been reached thus far. It is an agreement to agree. Following these preliminary agreements, there will be a larger, more complete written contract. This type of agreement is said to be subject to contract. That would mean you should be expecting a full written contract with all the terms and clause in the contract. Domestic and social arrangement. When looking into domestic and social arrangement, we should be looking at the leading case Balfour versus Balfour. The leading case Balfour versus Balfour is a case where a husband and wife had some problem. The husband promised to pay the wife an allowance. The wife didn't receive it for several months. The wife brought this to court and won. The Court of Appeal reversed the decision because there was no intention that they should be attended by legal consequences. Atkin LJ states that the common law does not regulate the form of agreements between spouses. Their promises are not sealed with seals and sealing wax. The consideration that really obtains for them is that natural love and affection which counts for so little in these cold courts. The family arrangements are not intended to produce legal consequences. The main doctrine from Balfour is that cohabitation agreement, which party who agree to cohabit set forth the terms and condition under which they will conduct their domestic affair, are unenforceable. However, there are some provinces who have had statutory modernization of provincial family law. These provinces would enact legislation that would provide marriage contracts or cohabitation agreements to be constituted as enforceable contract. The end.